Hello, I'm Naomi Craig. I'm happy to be here with you today. Thanks for tuning in. Today I am giving you a 5-minute book review on Scrumptious Independence by Melissa Wardwell. This is published by Celebrate Lit Publishing. That's kind of bad that I stumbled on that because that's my publisher too. This is a really fun series by Celebrate Lit, and it's a series that's compiled of several different authors. And it's called Independence Island, and each author has a few books that they will write in the series. The concept, the precept is that trucks, like Independence Island, is off the coast of Georgia, and they are so far away that they have to have a whole day trip just to go get their hair cut or get their dog groomed or whatever. So the concept is to bring all of these amenities on the islands in mobile businesses, so they can island hop. On Monday I'll be here, and on Tuesday I'll be at the next island and stuff like that. So this is called Scrumptious Independence by Melissa Wardwell, and as the name suggests, she is a food truck lady. So it's fun. It's really delicious sounding food. So let me get right into my review. Here it is. I had to find. I'm like, I know I have notes here somewhere. Let me get into my review for Scrumptious Independence by Melissa Wardwell. Here it is. All right. So 5-point review. Number one, Beth is a Yankee with a lot of money and a food truck dream. Number two, Scott is her best friend from high school summer camp all those years ago. Number three, patsies and meatloaf sandwiches and French toast and many other delicious sounding food offerings. And number four, locals who decidedly did not want this Yankee there. There's danger and intrigue as some of them try to foil her every move. And then number five, the quote to wrap it all up is, down here, friends are family, not by genetics, but by choice. So this was a sweet read, literally, right? And it's such a fun series. And it had some really good, strong, like, moments, like, about the intrigue and, people trying to do harm to Beth, and stuff like that. It was neat to see how Beth and her and Scott reconnected after all these years. But I felt like it was missing a couple of steps. Like, it would tell me, it would set me up for this intrigue, and someone wishing harm on her, and then I didn't like. It just kind of wrapped it up really nice. So I would like to see some more details on that, on some of the things. So, but it was a fun book. Again, you're gonna be hungry when you read these because these sound absolutely amazing. I think that Beth is very brave to go away from her family to set up a business, especially in a place where she's not feeling the love. In some senses, but again, I personally would like to see a little bit more. Like, it's built up, and I'd like to see the completion of some of these thoughts and ideas. And this was a very descriptive book, and I definitely would eat at Comfort Cuisine if it was here in my area, for sure. So anyway, there we are. We are less than 5 minutes. There you go. I did receive a copy of this, a complimentary copy of Scrumptious Independence from Celebrate Lit Publishing. This in no way influenced my review, and the opinions are my own. If you'd like to catch my next review, feel free to subscribe to my channel, and then you'll be alerted when I pull up my next book review for your enjoyment. So, until next time, I hope you have a lovely book to read, and don't forget to leave a review. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Naomi Craig.